What's up, everybody?
What's up?
I feel like we should go ahead and just say Merry Christmas,
because Merry Christmas.
We're basically there already, right?
I mean, hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king.
That was beautiful.
Thank you.
I really like that.
That's
that
as good as it gets, though.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. Well, I feel like we should go ahead and celebrate our VIPs that are here today. VIPs, if you don't know what that means, it means a very important person, because you're a first-time guest. I'm so glad you're here today. If it is your first time, Jerry, what should they do?
They should stick around, because we got some instructions for you later.
That's right. And hang tight, because we're going to have so much fun today and we want you to be here for all of it. So,
Hey, Liz, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
2024 years ago, who was a VIP?
Was Jesus?
It was Jesus.
I love that. That's amazing, because that's how long ago that Jesus was born. Big brain.
It's big brain okay. Calculations.
Well, speaking of Jesus, we are celebrating him all month long. This is a very special month where we celebrate the birth of Jesus and all that God did for us. So we are going to talk about...
Yes, we're going to learn that you can have joy because God sent Jesus.
That was a really good transition there.
Thank you.
Yeah, good job. Yes, you can have joy because God sent Jesus. I love that. I love having joy. And that's kind of like one of our songs that we are going to sing today, right?
Oh, cool.
I know. Yeah. But Jerry, can you tell me, is there anything that comes to mind whenever you think of having joy?
Yes. I can think of a time. Oh, okay. So like right now, you know, since I'm stuck in the internet.
Yes.
I asked Daryl to order me a Tesla Cybertruck. Because it's a cyber truck. And so that way I can get away from those carolers who've been chasing me all month.
And has that worked out for you so far?
It's on its way. I think it's being sent through the intertubes.
Okay, that sounds a little bit sketchy. I don't know if it's gonna...
I'm pretty sure cyber truck means it's a cyber truck, not like a real truck, right?
I don't think so. I don't think that's right.
Okay, we made a gross miscalculation. This is a very expensive mistake.
That's a big mistake. Take Jerry.
Oh, no.
And that's not really exactly what we're talking about. So we'll kind of go into more of that later.
Okay.
All right. But I think now, what time is it now?
Oh, it's definitely time for the Liz Quiz.
No, it's not. It's not time for the Liz
Yes,
Quiz.
It is.
No, I think because of Christmas and everyone being super nice to each other on Christmas, we should make sure that we don't do the Liz Quiz, because I'm going to probably have to eat something crazy.
Yeah. No, I think we should do the Liz Quiz, because the gift we're giving to the kids at home is good content. And we're gonna make them watch you eat something weird.
All right. Let's just go into it.
Okay. All right. Here we go. Here's our question for the Liz Quiz. A bunch of angels appeared when Jesus was born, and they said something. Fill in the blank with the right word.
Okay.
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his blank rests.
Oh, that was that your angel impersonation?
No, I actually got a real angel to do that.
Okay.
So that wasn't me.
Whatever.
Okay. So peace to those on whom his blank rests. Is it glory? Is it love? Is it kindness? Or is it favor?
Okay, well, I will tell you, I think I know this one. I'm going to have to go with favor. Yes! I knew it. I got it right. That means I get to pick which cookie I'm going to have to eat. So we'll see what kind of icing is on it. I'll be able to examine it a little bit and hopefully pick one with actual icing and not anything weird on top of it.
Well, we'll see.
Okay.
We'll see. Maybe it's so muted that you can't tell until you bite into it.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll think about that later. Well, anyway, winning the Liz Quiz definitely gave me joy today. And so we're going to continue this joyous occasion by focusing on worshiping Jesus. And we're going to sing a song that talks about joy. I'm so, so excited. So everybody, let's go ahead and stand on up to our feet as we get ready to worship God.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature. truth and grace. It makes the nations rue the glories of his righteousness and wonders of his love and wonders of his love.
Down a little bit. Sometimes when we worship, we close our eyes and lift our hands. When we close our eyes, we're focusing on God. When we lift our hands, it's like giving God all of our problems and trusting in Him. So let's focus on Him now.
Children weep no more. Hope is on the horizon. Weary world behold. Your promise, Messiah. Angels, let your song begin. Here comes heaven. Christ is born in Bethlehem. Here comes heaven.
Great job, everybody. I love worshiping God. That was so, so much fun. You guys can go ahead and have a seat now, okay? Today, we're learning that we can have joy because God sent Jesus. That means no matter what's going on in our lives, we can always have joy because of Jesus and what He did for us. Here comes Story Lab to help us see what it looks like to choose joy, even when we're in the middle of a mess.
Why can't I find it?
Find what?
The end to the string.
You mean this?
Oh.
Welcome to Story Lab. This week, we're talking about Christmas as we learn how the light of the world got here in the first place.
I sure don't know how I ended up here.
I'm Skylar.
And I'm Sebastian.
We're talking about Christmas, which is celebrating Jesus, God's greatest gift.
We're also still decorating our Christmas tree. Hey, should we plug these in?
Let's light it up.
Yo, that's awesome.
You know, these lights remind me of something.
An experiment?
It's kind of a mix between art and electronics.
So, illuminate us.
Let's make it.
For this experiment, we're going to need a graphite pencil, a piece of paper, a 9-volt battery, some tape, and a simple light-emitting diode, or LED for short.
Wait, LED is short for a light-emitting diode?
Diode.
Diode. I thought it was for live electronic dance music. So what is a diode?
A diode is a one-way street for an electric current. When the electric current is flowing the right direction, a light-emitting diode will light up.
So we're gonna make this diode light up with this? Because I kind of think that would be a Christmas miracle.
Let's start by drawing something Christmassy. I think I will draw a Christmas tree.
Okay, I'll draw an advent candle.
So we have to leave a place for the LED and a space where the battery goes.
Hmm.
I think I'm going to leave a space at the top of my Christmas tree and at the bottom of my Christmas tree.
The LED will be your star.
Brilliant, right?
I see what you did there. I think I can leave space at the top of my candle for an LED flame.
So the graphite is actually conductive, which means it'll carry an electric current from the power source to the LED.
And our power source is the battery.
Yes. Almost done?
No.
So that we can have a stronger electric current, it's very important that you make the graphite a little more thick.
Like an inch thick?
About half an inch. Almost done?
All done.
Okay, now we need to label the positive and negative sides. The right side can be positive, and the left side can be negative. Okay. Now let's tape our light-emitting diodes down.
Light-emitting diodes, that is just fun to say.
The longer side of the LED is the positive side.
All right.
And once we have them taped down, we can get our 9-volt batteries ready.
Hold on, lights down. 3, 2, 1.
It worked!
It's amazing how one little sketch can light up the page.
Speaking of light, it's time for
the story before the story.
Today, we're in the third book of the New Testament, Luke.
God had a plan to bless the whole world through one family, the Israelites.
But God's people kept turning away. At last, they were attacked by foreign nations.
Even in this time of trouble, God spoke through prophets and promised to send a rescuer.
Then, after hundreds of years, God sent an angel to an ordinary girl named Mary and told her she was going to have a very special baby, which is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey, everyone. I'm Erica. Mary and her husband Joseph began making plans for the new baby. But the land where God's people lived had been taken over by the Romans. Because of this, the Jewish people had to pay taxes to the Roman government. From time to time, the Roman ruler would order that all the people be counted and their names recorded. This is called a census.
More people, more money. Count them all so we can squeeze every last denarius from them. All persons in the province of Judea must return to their family home to be counted for the Roman census.
When Joseph heard this, he was a little nervous. Joseph wasn't too excited to tell Mary she had to go on a journey when she was going to have a baby. But they had no choice. And do you know where Joseph's hometown was? Of course, Bethlehem. Mary and Joseph were living in Nazareth. Bethlehem was about 80 miles away. 80 miles is a long way to walk. especially when you're ready to have a baby. The journey would have taken close to a week, so they would have had to sleep on the ground at night.
How are you feeling?
Let's say camping isn't my favorite right now.
It's likely that Joseph had family living in Bethlehem. He and Mary may have planned to stay with relatives when they arrived. But once they got there, no one had any beds available. And so Joseph and Mary ended up in the only place there was still room, with the animals. Imagine sleeping in a small room with a bunch of farm animals. It was kind of like that. And while they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby.
He's so perfect.
We'll call him Jesus.
Mary swaddled baby Jesus and laid him in the feeding trough, or manger, because there was no cradle. In the midst of all that mess, Mary and Joseph chose joy. They knew that God had kept the promise to send a rescuer. And as they stared at Jesus, they knew he would be great. He would be called the Son of the Most High, and his kingdom would never end. The end. Or is it a new beginning?
How incredible is that? The savior of the whole world has to sleep in a feeding trough.
I bet the cows were a little confused.
No kidding.
So, what's our part in the story?
Mary and Joseph chose joy in a difficult situation. They saw how God had fulfilled a promise, and they trusted that God was at work. Jesus is the light of the world. Because of Jesus, our broken relationship with God can be restored. And one day, God will make everything right again. So just like Mary, we can choose joy in the midst of our own messy lives.
Like when your Christmas lights are tangled,
you can choose joy.
Or maybe someone gives you socks for Christmas.
I like socks.
You can still choose joy.
How about when my mom makes a meal I don't really like?
Or you lose your voice and you can't sing in your Christmas concert.
Both great times to choose joy.
And Jesus can help us do that.
Absolutely. When you choose to follow Jesus, God sends the Holy Spirit to be with you. Joy is actually a gift from the Holy Spirit.
So Jesus is our connection back to God.
Sounds like you've got it. See you next time. Oh, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
So here's the thing. You can have joy because God sent Jesus. He is the light of the world.
And even if your Christmas lights are a little tangled, you can still choose joy.
Mind if I shed some light on the situation?
Please help.
You betcha. Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab.
See you next time, and Merry Christmas.
Wow, everybody. Mary and Joseph were in the middle of a mess, but they chose to have joy because God had kept his promise and sent Jesus. I'm so glad God sent us Jesus because Jesus did something very, very special for us. Let's watch this video to learn more about that together. Okay, everyone, I want to share a very special story with you called The Good News. Repeat that after me, okay? The Good News. But before I can get into the good news, I'm afraid I do have some bad news. The bad news is that we have all done some wrong things called sin. Sin is anything that hurts others and goes against what God says. Not just big things, but small things too, like cheating on a test, or telling a lie, or being unkind to your brother or sister. Our sin separates us from God and keeps us from having a relationship with Him. That means God is way over here and we're way over there. And that's bad news for us because the punishment for sin isn't something like time out or jail. It's actually separation from God forever. But here's the thing. God loves you. He loves you so much that he made a way for you to be with him again because he doesn't want to be apart from you. So what did he do? He sent his son Jesus to help. And Jesus did something incredible. He decided to die for you. Jesus never did anything wrong, but he took all the punishment of our sins by dying on a cross.
He died instead of us. What's even more amazing is that he didn't stay dead. 3 days later, he rose from the dead. God is stronger, so much stronger than death. This is why we celebrate Christmas, because Jesus was born on earth so he could save us. Did you know that Jesus wants to be a part of your life? He does. He loves you and wants to have a relationship with you. And if we want to have Jesus be a part of our life, all we have to do is admit we're a sinner, believe Jesus is God's son and that he came to save us, and ask him to forgive us from our sins. When we do this, Jesus becomes the leader of our life, and we'll go to heaven one day and spend forever with God. But it's not just about heaven. When Jesus is your leader, God will be with you here on earth too. He'll be here to help you and guide you and show you how to live your life for him. You can even talk to him. He'll be your friend and your leader forever. And that is not just good news, it's great news. Aren't you so glad that God gave us Jesus as a gift? God sent Jesus so we can have a relationship with him, even though we've all sinned. If you feel like you want to take the next step and ask Jesus into your heart as the leader of your life, tell the people who take care of you that you want to know more about starting a relationship with Jesus. They can help you take the next step. In fact, after today's episode ends, click on the link in the description below and have a grown-up tell us about your decision to ask Jesus to be your savior and live for God. Wow, guys, that is such an amazing story. God promised he would make everything right in the end, so we can have hope because we know he's faithful. By the way, if you have any questions about Jesus or you want to know what it means to accept him into your heart, make sure you let your group leader know and they can help answer questions. Alika's going to help us learn more about this in group time. Let's get into it.
Hey, friends, what's up? It's Alika and I have my son,
A.B.
And it's time for group time. Group time. What? Group time. What? And freeze. Awesome. Okay, bro. I'm so excited to talk with you and all of our friends. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Because today we're talking about joy. And that is something that Daddy has a lot of, is joy. Do you guys have joy in your life? Do you have joy in your life?
Yes!
That's awesome. That's what it looks like and sounds like, y'all. But the cool thing is this, is that joy comes. We can have joy because God sent Jesus. Because at the end of the day, Jesus saved all of us from our sins. And so we can have joy. Isn't that super cool?
Yeah.
Okay, so AB, check this out. I got a cool question. What makes you happy? Like, what are things that make you happy?
Going to the movie theaters.
What's the last movie we watched at the movie theaters?
The last movie that we watched. It was supposed to be The Little Mermaid, but nah, it was the last movie that we watched at the movie theaters was the Super Mario Brothers.
Why you say it like that? We watch it a lot, actually. We've watched it so many times. Okay, well, bro, okay, so with joy, right, AB? So check this out, with joy, what is, ooh, I got a funny question.
Okay.
It's almost Christmas. It's Christmas time. Look at our sweaters, like our Christmas sweaters. Okay, AB, so check this out. What is your favorite Christmas song?
That's hard. I think it's Jingle Bells.
I was literally gonna say Jingle Bells. Oh, okay. What's your favorite Christmas song? But you said it's Jingle Bells, right? Okay, you have to sing. Let's play a game. You have to sing Jingle Bells for 5 seconds. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. How do you feel when you sang that song?
Happy!
That is so funny. Because, dude, happiness is joy, AB. All this that's happening right now, it's joy. And the cool thing is that it all comes from God. Isn't that cool? Okay, so I think this is the perfect transition because I think when we talk about God, we need to know his word. So let's talk about the memory verse for this month, which is Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. You ready?
Yeah.
Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. What brings you joy? Okay, so let's say it's Christmas Day. What are things that bring you joy on that day? Or something that makes you have joy or makes you happy that morning when Christmas happens?
Happy to celebrate Jesus' birthday!
Happy to celebrate Jesus' birthday?
Yes.
Okay. And how do we celebrate Jesus' birthday? At the end of the day, we're celebrating Jesus. Yes. And we've talked about it all month, whether that's God having a plan for us and God giving peace for us,
yes.
Right? That it all comes from God. And it's about Jesus, right? And so friends, as we and you and your family, however you guys celebrate Christmas, remember that you can have joy because God has given it to us. And you can have peace because God has given it to you as well. Cool? Well, I think that's the perfect time for us to pray because it's Christmas time, AB. And it's time to celebrate Jesus. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's pray. Jesus, we thank you, God, for this day. We thank you, God, for Christmas and the celebration of your son, Jesus. Thank you, God, for giving us joy and giving us the ability to live a joyful life. We love you and we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
We did it!
Peace out! All right, friends, ready for our memory verse challenge? I'm gonna show you a new game called Gotcha to help you learn this month's verse. Because you're learning scripture, this is a great way to help us know how God wants us to live. This month's verse is Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, which actually says, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given." Remember, we're celebrating Jesus all month long, and this verse will help us remember what a special gift he is. Here's what I'll do to play Gotcha. I'm going to start by saying a verse out loud to my friend Sydney. Can everyone say hi, Sydney?
Hi.
But I'm going to choose one word to get wrong on purpose. So here's an example. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 says, "For to us a child is here, to us a son is given."
Gotcha. You said here, and you should have said born.
Ah, that's it. That's what it is. Okay, Sydney. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. "For to me a child is born, to us a son is given."
Gotcha. You said me, and it's us, right?
Ah, okay, you got me.
You made me doubt myself there. I was like, right? Did I get you?
You did.
I gotcha.
Okay, you tried.
I gotcha. Okay, okay.
Okay, I'm ready.
This is my comfort Bible. I'm just holding it. Okay. "For to us a child is born, to us an apple is given."
I do like apples.
Yeah.
But gotcha! You said apples, and it's actually supposed to be sun. That's awesome! Okay, so try this week with someone. If they don't know the verse, that's okay. You can challenge them to read the verse to you straight from the Bible and just replace any word they want with the wrong word. If they know the verse too, you can see if they can catch the word and replace it with the actual word. You can say, gotcha. You've been doing great memorizing Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. Keep it up so we can help you remember to celebrate Jesus as we get closer to Christmas.
I love Christmas.
I think we're just about ready for game time now, so let's go see what's going on. Peace.
Bye. All right, guys, are you ready? This week's subject is Bible.
Ooh.
I'm gone.
Oh.
Showtime.
Make sure you answer with us. First question, what are the names of the four gospel books? Five, four, three, two, one. We got Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
He's right.
Mark, Luke, and Matthew.
John with no H.
John, it looks like Jim. We got Matt, Mark, Luke, and John. Mark, Luke, Matthew, John. Mark, Luke, Matthew, and Jim. Okay, the actual answer is Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. So I think it's like 1 point for everyone.
Yeah.
We got it. Okay, are you guys ready for the next question?
Ready.
Yes.
Who wrote the book of Revelation?
Wow. I feel like JT knows this.
Who wrote the book of Revelation?
Why would you do this to me?
Five,
Five.
I need to write, read my Bible.
Three, two, one. Let me see your answers.
What Paul.
We've got John, Paul, and Paul. Okay. Guys, the answer is John. John was the author
Island of Patmos,
of the book Revelation.
I think, you know what I'm saying?
Nice. Okay, next question. What does the word Jesus mean? What does the word Jesus
this
mean?
This guy. He just that got guy. It.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. Let me see your answers. We have Jesus equals love, Messiah, Savior, and Mr. What does that say at the top?
Oh, don't ignore that.
Oh, I'm okay. Savior healer. I was like, Mr. Savior healer. Okay, the actual answer is Savior.
Oh! Oh dang!
I don't know what it is.
That was panic mode, literally. Okay, next question.
Oh, no.
Name three of Jesus' disciples whose names begin with J.
What?
You got this. Three, two, one.
Put this one in here for you.
Let's see your answers. Okay, and the answer is Jacob, John, and Judas. And Jacob could be Jacob or James, because he went by both, right? Yeah. How'd you guys do? Not well.
Two out of three. Forgot okay. Judas. Can't believe yeah. that.
Judas. Okay, our last question. Who wrote Acts? Who wrote the book of Acts? I don't know. Do you know? All right, I'll give you 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's see. Paul.
Mine doesn't
Luke,
make sense.
Paul.
David,
win it out. It's David. Okay, the actual answer is Luke.
Yeah. Oh, good job, JT.
Wow. Nice. Okay, let's see how you guys did. Let's see your points. We have 1, 3, 2, and 1. So our winner is JT.
Good job, JT.
How did you guys do? We'll have a chance to play again next week, so we'll see you then. Bye.
Wow, guys, I have had so much fun today. I'm so glad you guys were all with us, and we are just gonna have so much fun continuing to celebrate Jesus all month long. And VIPs, remember, I had some special instructions for you guys. There's a link below this video. You should tell your parents or the person who takes care of you who's in your home that this link is especially for them because they can send us some information for us to reach back out to you and say hi. Okay, everybody, it's time to pray. Let's make sure that we respect God and that we focus on Him during our prayer. So let's close our eyes and bow our heads. Here we go. Lord, we love you so much. Thank you that you sent Jesus to us and we can have so much joy because of that. Help us to have joy all the time. In Jesus' name, everyone said, amen. Okay, guys, I had so much fun today. And now it's time to see what kind of cookies that Jerry has today. Let's get into it. Here's the situation. These cookies look a lot like other cookies that I was offered a couple weeks ago. And so that makes me even more suspicious that maybe like since the blue one was the good one last time, it's the bad one this time. Or they're trying to trick me and get in my head to think it's the bad one, but it's actually the good one.
Liz, we've officially reached the point where you're paranoid.
Well, of course
this
I am.
This is not healthy.
I had to eat a cookie with ketchup on it last week.
Well, I mean, but both of these could be good. You don't know.
I don't think that's how it works.
I'll tell you what. Make a deal with you.
What?
If you take a bite of it and it's not good, I'll let you take a bite of the other to see if it's good.
Oh, okay.
Sure. So why don't you just, yeah. I think since you got it right.
Oh, wait, what if they're both bad, though? Are you tricking me?
Again, you're being really paranoid. Why are you like this, Liz?
I don't want to eat
Liz,
something gross.
Who hurt you?
You did when you fed me a ketchup cookie.
No way.
It's so gross. Okay, all right. Well, I guess we should probably get into it then. I'm going to pick, you know what? I'm gonna go big or go home. I'm going to pick the red one this time.
Great choice.
Oh, does that mean it's not?
I mean, you could mix up your answer. You want to go for the other one?
Should I? Are you trying to trick me?
I'm in your head.
You are definitely in my head. All right. I don't know. This is it. Okay. I guess I'll just go for it.
Go for it.
Here we go.
Oh! What is that?
I think it's Italian seasoning.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
It's so gross.
Here, take a bite of the other one. The other one's good.
Oh,
Liz, the other one's good. Wash it out.
Oh, it's so gross. What on earth? Jerry, it's like I ate like a salad and a pasta on a cookie.
Gross. All yeah, right. That one's better.
Okay. Wait, hold on. Whip. Whip. What is that?
Caesar dressing.
No.
You've been duped again,
you
Liz.
You tricked me. What?
You've been duped.
Jerry, that's so mean. That is so nasty. I thought that one was going to be good and it was going to taste like sugar so it would drown out the other Italian stuff. Oh, no.
The other Italian stuff.
Oh, dear. Okay, so here's the thing. Next week, I have to get it right so I get to pick
yes.
which cookie. You literally gave me a plate of cookies with that were both bad.
Yeah, sorry. Man, that must have been a mistake on my end.
Okay,
Whoopsie.
Okay.
Whoopsie.
All right, well, I got to drink more water. So you guys are going to have to come back next week and cheer me on so that I actually get something right this time, okay? All right, so you want to say bye, Jerry?
Bye, Jerry.
Bye, guys.
Show. I'm Brandon.
And I'm John. Oh, we are closer and closer to my favorite day of the year.
So close.
But not close enough.
Oh, come on. Christmas is right around the corner.
Yeah, another 7 days away.
I know what will make you jolly.
Christmas carols!
What's your favorite carol?
Oh, I'd have to say Carol Burnett. She's so funny.
No.
Carol Channing's number two.
That's not.
And number three's gotta be Carol O'Connor, though the spelling's different.
Not a person named Carol.
Oh.
A carol is a joyful song. And since we usually sing them during the joyous season of Christmas, what's your favorite Christmas song?
Oh, Deck the Halls.
Mine too.
Really?
No. Oh. Let's sing it.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la.
What is it? Why did you stop?
What in the world?
What?
Those lyrics, have you ever thought about them?
Deck the halls with boughs of holly?
Yeah, what does that mean?
Well, I mean, maybe it means to punch the hall walls, you know, like you're gonna deck them in a fight.
Okay, yeah, but what about boughs of holly? Boughs of holly.
I guess someone named Holly is there, and she's bowing a lot. So.
Okay, 'tis the season to be jolly is pretty self-explanatory. Don we now our gay apparel.
Oh, that means to put on your festive clothes.
Ah.
What are yours?
An ugly Christmas sweater and flip-flops.
Oh, at the same time?
No.
Okay.
But now that you mention it.
Yeah, put that away.
Oh.
Okay, troll the ancient Yuletide carol.
Troll.
Oh. Troll.
Yes, of course, with the...
What is that?
It's a Yule log. Troll the ancient Yule log.
Not Yule log, that's a Swiss cake roll. And besides, it's not Yule log, it's Yuletide. Yuletide means the Christmas season. And Yuletide Carol is a joyous Christmas song. Yule log is completely different.
Well, troll means to sing loudly, so your silly little troll doll isn't right either. Let me,
Okay, so, troll, the ancient Yuletide Carol, means to loudly sing an old, joyous Christmas song.
Shall we?
We shall. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la.
Don we now our gay apparel,
la 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 la.
Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la.
It's Bible story time.
Hey guys! Let me guess. You were trolling.
We sure were.
Yeah, but like in the olden days, not like an internet troll.
Yeah. Ah, so you were singing loudly.
Yeah.
Was Carol there?
No, but Holly was.
Oh, good.
You know what also sounds good right now? A Christmas story to go with our Christmas carol. You got one?
I sure do. Today's story comes from the book of Luke, who wrote about the birth of Jesus. Jesus's birth is a joyous moment, and you can have joy because God sent Jesus to be on earth with us. You can also be joyful that here to help me tell the story today are the So and So Show Players. Yay! Last time, we learned how the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary in the town of Nazareth. Gabriel told Mary she was going to give birth to a son and call him Jesus. Now, in those days, Caesar Augustus, the Roman emperor, made a law.
I am making a law. I require a list to be made of everyone in the whole Roman Empire.
The kind of list he was talking about was called a census.
A census, yes, that's what I want.
Everyone went to their own town to be listed, including Joseph, the man Mary was engaged to.
Okay, since I am from the family line of David.
Yeah.
Let's see, we've gotta go all the way to the little town of Bethlehem. So, if Nazareth is that way, then Bethlehem must be that way?
No, honey. This way.
Right, down that road. Let's go.
Shouldn't we have like a donkey?
Oh, probably. But Luke didn't write that part down.
Luke?
Forget about it.
Okay.
We're still going the right way, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I knew that.
You got this, honey.
Yeah, I got this. I got this.
Mary and Joseph had a long journey ahead of them. They traveled many days, but thankfully, they arrived safely. And while they were in Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born.
What is it, Mary?
It's time. It's time.
Oh, it's time. Okay, don't panic.
Okay.
Not sure Joseph was going that crazy, but it's possible. Since everyone was in the town for the census, all the guest rooms were filled with people. There wasn't enough space for Mary and Joseph. They searched the town for a place to give birth.
Excuse me, do you have a room for me and my pregnant wife?
No.
Oh, hello. My wife is about to give birth to a very special child.
It's what all mothers say.
Pardon me!
Hey, Joseph. It's no use. There's no room.
Hey! Well, we have room with the animals.
We'll take it!
Mary and Joseph were finally taken to a place where animals like goats and lambs were kept, which was a fitting place for the Lamb of God. It was there that Mary had her baby.
A beautiful baby boy.
Jesus.
The end. Give it up for the so-and-so show players. Yay! Hey, no more trolling?
It was itchy.
I bet Mary and Joseph were worried when they couldn't find a place to stay.
I bet they were, but they remained faithful and determined. And the joy they felt when they finally held Jesus in their arms was better than any pain or fear they had. See, that's one thing we can remember. Whenever life gets stressful or difficult, especially during the busy season like this one, we can have joy because God loved us so much to send Jesus.
That's beautiful. Hey, thanks for the story.
No problem. See you next time.
Bye.
You know, we've had a great show singing Deck the Halls, really putting me in the Christmas spirit.
Me too. And that Bible story is one of my favorites. It always brings me joy.
Oh, I know Joy. She's really great.
Oh, yeah? Is she friends with Carol?
Best friends. Mm.
Reveal the question. What makes your Christmas joyful?
For me, it's sitting by the fire on a cold winter day, surrounded by family and friends I love.
And for me, it's singing Christmas carols door to door, bringing cheer to my community.
For you, maybe it's cooking a special dinner with those holiday treats you only eat once a year.
Yeah, with extended family you probably only see during this time. Yeah. That's what makes this season so incredible.
But one thing we can all be joyful for is that God sent Jesus.
Yep, that's the greatest gift we can all receive.
What's the second greatest gift?
Oh. This.
Yay!
So talk about it together. What makes your Christmas joyful?
And we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show. Oh, these are great. I haven't had these in a while.
No, but you did. Remember during the music video, you ate a whole plate of
them. That's what these are?
Yeah, this is Swiss cake rolls. Oh, no.